What afternoon, dear visitors. Let me present the main result of the study of the topic, Branding Theory, Design and Identity, course teaching experience for modern IT specialists. The modern world requires modern approaches in all areas of human activity, and education is not an exception. Ukraine and the world need high-quality specialists in different areas who can quickly, creatively, and effectively solve non-standard tasks. Each future specialist in a different field, especially in the IT field, should always be ready to solve super complex tasks using the ability to analyze, make quick decisions, and find non-standard ways out of the current situation. The main focus of the work of teaching preparing IT specialists is to create conditions for the creativity activity of students, while it's not only necessary to simulate the desire of creativity in chair in everyone. The organization of the educational process with the inclusion of elements of creative activity will make it possible to educate a comprehensive development specialist who will have an innovative approach to future professional activities. The development of creativity also contributes to a better solution for programming problems. The formation of a specialist as a creative person capable of self-development, self-education, and innovation is one of the main tasks of higher education. The main focus of the work of teaching preparing a teacher specialist is to create conditions for the creativity activity of students, while it's not only necessary to simulate the desire for creativity in chair in everyone. At the Zhytomyr Polytechnic State University, students of the IT industry study the discipline Branding Theory, Design and Identity. When studying this discipline, students often turn to creative research, develop analytical skills, and independently go through the entire life cycle of a brand. After completing the course, students can work with direction of design, namely the development of corporate identity or promotional products. As part of the course Branding Theory, Design and Identity, the main goal is to prepare high-quality specialists in the direction of developing a corporate identity and developing the corporate abilities of specialists studying technical specialty. The main topic of studying this course are introduction, types of computer graphics, logo, corporate style constants, logo formation of palette and corporate colors and fonts, corporate business documentation, work with raster graphics, mockups, rule for the design of outdoor advertising, combination of raster and vector graphic, corporate website and advertising on the internet, composition and visual hierarchy in web design, point of sales, post types, brand book development, design rules, work with the customers, principle of project presentation, corporate periodical. Studying the first topic, students get acquainted with the concept of branding and corporate identity. When entering the discipline, special attention is paid to the review of exciting brands, the study of the history of the creation of their corporate identity, and changes in the process of rebranding. For more detail, immersion is the concept of branding and consolidation of the studied stages. Students need to prepare a presentation using free software on the topic corporate identity of the world famous brand. As a result of completing the task, student creates the image of the brand and understands the approaches to its creation. The next stage in students' work is to improve skill in vector graphics, which becomes the basis for creative corporate identity constructs. The basic of the entire course is the third term. It's built such a way after completing all tasks, student receives the basic element of corporate identity. The first task of its term is to create a mood board. The next important stage in the work of students is the study of competitive market is chosen field. By doing research, you can ensure a high quality and unique design while avoiding plagiarisms in the name and style features. After it, students move on to the most important stage is development of corporate identity, a logo. To begin with, sketches are developed based on reference project. From the sketches, one version of the logo is selected, which is necessary finalized and present. During the study of this topic, students form a palette of corporate colors with a description of the style load and select font pairs, indicating their combination and use in advertising, souvenirs, and branded business documentation. When studying this topic again, as experience show, students present a whole range of developments of their topic, which involves several stages. To begin with, market research, competitors, and the uniqueness of the product or service are presented. At the same time, the concept of work is based on thorough study of the topic and the history of the product. After the development and technical description of corporate identity constants, students proceed to the design of business documentation. The next step is to create the next step in creative and the identity of the select company, student to develop corporate business documentation. The task consists of design business card and letterhead and design envelopes for correspondence. Students start to use a mockup file that have been downloaded from open web resources for presentation thereof. Expanding the set of corporate identity elements, students move on to creative layouts for advertising media, billboards and signboards. When getting acquainted with the topic of outdoor advertising, an important step to get acquainted with the principle of creating a unique advertising offer, the principle of advertising design and matching the layout to the corporate style. The outdoor advertising media provides for creation clearly shows the rules for using corporate identity in advertising. During the presentation of layout, student test for completeness with the design and localization of the advertising media site. Advertising design is a new direction for students. When developing advertising layouts, each of students analyze the exciting, high quality and popular advertising form their advertising offer and present them on the approved sites. Another important direction in the corporate style of the company is the dissemination of information about the brand on the internet. The task is to create the main pages of corporate website. When designing the main page of the site, students must follow the rules of their own corporate identity and corporate style. Use corporate colors and fonts, displaying the company's theme in the smallest details of web design. The next task is to develop banners for advertising on the internet. In banners, students form three different promotional offers to promote the company on web pages and social network. The results of the work is a presentation of the corporate website design and a set of three banners for advertising on the internet. When performing this work, the ability of students is to use of various software tools and web resources in Upsor. Students are allowed to use available website builders and online editors to create interface prototypes. The final stage in the development of a line of souvenirs, a set of packing, and the development of the design for branded clothes for employers. The elements of souvenir products for each student may differ depending on the correspondence between the team of the project and souvenir products. Souvenirs, branded packaging, and clothing are designed by students by their own corporate identity. When demonstrating souvenir packing and branding clothes, students use mockup files. The main requirement was that students use a mockup of the same style, fit their subject, and the general concept of corporate identity. Final work of the course, Branding Theory, Design and Identity, is the formation of a company's brand book on the chosen topic, on which students work individually during the course. Well, project presentation option a printed version, an electronic version in PDF, or a brand book in the form of website. In the working version of the brand book, students include the following section: about the company, logo, corporate colors, corporate fonts, business documentation, outdoor advertising, souvenir products, branding packaging, branding clothes. When submitting the final project, each student will present his work on all the requirements of the presentation of project in IT companies. That determines the flexibility of introduced methodology for teaching the course Branding Theory, Design and Identity. An anonymous survey of students trained according to this methodology was conducted. Applicants for higher education must answer the following question. Do the course assign match the lecture materials and laboratory task? Do the topic fit the learning objective of the course? Select the topic that you think are totally necessary, select topic to remove, write down the topic you will think could be recovered in the course, and how interesting was the course for you. 42nd year study, students of specialty computer science were involved in the survey. Participation in survey was voluntary and anonymous. After walking through the results of survey, it was found the students were happy to study this course, and all the topics proposed for studies full consistency with the goals of the disciplines, since the students who participate in the survey study were only in second year. Everyone answered the same question. The results of the students' survey indicate that it's difficult for students to adapt quickly to creative environment. Part of the students have difficulties at the stage of forming the topic of the work. It's due to insufficient immersion of incorporated identity trends of companies of different direction and location. Since the beginning of work, the graphic component of the brand is the creation of a logo. Students feel a lack of material what forming the concept and idea of the brand. Formation of the brand's mission and philosophy is an important stage in the development of corporate identity. As a solution to this problem, within laboratory task, which presents the creation of the logo, students are offered to delve into the topic of their choice. Analyze the relevance of the product or service, research the competitive market locally, define the relevance of the products or service offered by them among other on the market, form the target audience and develop user portraits, describe the philosophy of the brand and form a mission. The next problem the student face in the presentation of work. After all, the success of the project as a whole depends on the presentation of materials. Most students lack oral presentation skill and use outdated resources to present visual materials. The solution to this problem is to provide students with electronic resources of a collection of mockups that they can use in their work. Regarding that was most memorable when studying this discipline, the students indicate that it was the opportunity to use any means, the teacher's creativity approach to task and according students, implementation of tasks. Summing up and taking into account the interviews of students conducted during the defense of final works, the main advantages and the disadvantages of the proposed methodology were defined. Among disadvantages are a complex adaptation of technical students in a completely creative environment, insufficient amount of lecture material for perfect mastery of graphic editors. Benefits include improving the skill of presentation, development of creative thinking, improving individual thinking, application of acquired skills in vocational education. As a result of taking the course Branding Theory, Design and Identity, students learn creativity, search and analyst, learn the stage of brand formation. Each of the course participants develop their own corporate identity and prepare the working version of the brand book by the evaluation criteria. The course methodology allows students to develop such competency as ability to apply knowledge in practical situation, the ability to generate new ideas, and the ability to search, process, and analyze information from different sources. During the training, students show the ability to creatively approach tasks, easily master different graphic editors, and successfully combine them in practice. During the implementation of this methodology, we discovered some difficulties the students faced during their studies, namely the problem of repeat immersion in the creative space, the inefficient study of graphic editors, and a noticeable lack of materials for forming the concept and idea of a brand. Each of these problems will be worked out in detail by the author in the future, which will allow us to expand the course by adding new theoretical materials and some practical skills. The prospects for further research include the selection of criteria and indicators for the selection of digital learning tools for studying this course, as well as to carry out the appropriate expert selection. Thank you for your attention.